Hello there, my fellow researchers of the Ordo Xenos, and welcome back to a series which has been quite dormant for a while now. And the series is the lore on the minor Xenos races or factions of Warhammer 40k. For today, we actually have a very interesting, but also scary, sinister, and horrific topic in the form of the so-called Slaugth. And I do hope I'm actually pronouncing it right. This is gonna be just a one-off episode, as there isn't very much known about this race, and as you might expect, there aren't a lot of pictures either. I am your host, the Grimdark Narrator, and without further ado, let us proceed, shall we? The Slaugth are believed to be impossibly ancient, likely native to the Calyxis sector long before the arrival of humanity. Much of their known activity takes place around a region known as the Hazaroth Abyss, consisting of cursed space and dead stars. Their real homeworld is, however, unknown, and may not even be located in the Abyss. Their origins are also largely unknown in the Imperium, though rogue traders and Xeno savants believe that any empire they have lies out in the trailing halo stars. The circumstances of the first contact between humanity and the Slaugth is not known, although some sources claim that they have been encountered on the edge of Imperial space as far back as the Age of Strife. The abundance of humans in the galaxy has led to them becoming the favorite prey of the Slaugth. Despite this, they seem content in using infiltration and human agents to bring about their incomprehensible plan. Many of the encounters with these Xenos follow the same pattern, with black, tenebrous vessels entering Imperial space, where they wreak havoc on isolated outposts and shipping lines. The victims of the Slaugth are either left behind as mutilated bodies or disappear entirely. In other encounters, the Slaugth give their vile technology to renegade humans in exchange for slaves. Those Imperial worlds bordering the Hazaroth Abyss often tell stories describing the Slaugth as the worms that walk, a nightmare emerging from the depths of the Abyss to kill the living and feast on the dead. Ultimately, however, the upper echelons of the Imperium believe them to be nothing more than a myth. The Inquisition, though, does know they exist. Sealed archives claim that several frontier worlds of the Segmentum Obscurus have, over the millennia, been intentionally thrown into civil war, so that the Slaugth can invade and feed on the inhabitants. But even to those that are aware of the Slaugth, the ultimate goal of these inscrutable aliens remains a mystery. In truth, the real reason why the Slaugth avoid direct confrontation with the Imperium is because humanity greatly outnumbers them. While an individual human is not a match for a Slaugth, their greater numbers would mean that their kind would suffer greatly if the Imperium actually brought them to war. Despite this being the case, they are known to be preparing for the day when they will attack the Calyxis sector in a more open manner. The Stormwarden's chapter of Space Marines is known to have engaged the Slaugth and their warrior constructs on Vigil, during the events known as the Cleansing of Vigil. The conflict consisted of a series of bloody, close-range firefights, where conditions were so confined that it was impossible to deploy heavy armor. While the Stormwardens advanced cautiously and methodically, the Slaugth proved very adept at provoking the Astartes out of such careful tactics. Casualties grew as the battle raged on, and the Stormwardens' morale was sorely tested. But, ultimately, they succeeded in cleansing Vigil of the Slaugth menace, though at a great cost to themselves. In order to feed their constant hunger, the Slaugth have begun to turn their attention to the Calyxis sector, and have begun to destabilize the region by fomenting civil war and anarchy. They began by infiltrating the Amaranthine Syndicate, when it was just a fledgling trade cartel, and slowly moved in to control it completely. This patient approach may take several human generations to come to fruition, but it is a plan brilliant in its simplicity, relying on some good old-fashioned interminable human greed. The Slaugth provide humans with technology, wealth, and trinkets, encouraging mankind to tear itself apart over these items. When their plans have sufficiently advanced, they intend to further infiltrate other major criminal, political, and economic organizations of the Imperium, with the Ecclesiarchy and the Adeptus Administratum being targets. When the appointed time approaches, the Slaugth intend to see the sector collapse on itself, whereupon they will sweep into the region and have their way. Many regard the Xenos as a simple nightmarish myth, born as a void tale by mad rogue traders. The Inquisition knows them to be an active threat, however, though it has suppressed all knowledge of them for millennia. However, the Holy Ordos do remain unaware of the fact that the Amaranthine Syndicate is now under the command of the Slaugth. Their activity in the sector has also dramatically increased, spreading a network of their agents throughout the region. There is some dissension among their own ranks, though, with a splinter faction formed by a Slaugth known as Intendant Recusant, who has become consumed by addictive hunger. This entity is known to have broken free from his Dark Masters, and now leads Slaugth Infiltrators, a cadre of constructs and a faction of humans from the Amaranthine Syndicate in pursuit of his own goals. The Slaugth are also known as the Maggot Men, the Dream Eaters, and the Carrion Lords, whose bodies and minds are completely alien to humanity. Their roughly humanoid form stands about 3 meters tall. Their body has hundreds of maggot-like creatures covered in a viscous, necrotic mucus. These traits allow them to stretch and reform their body at will, allowing them to move with a boneless fluidity, along with the capacity to regenerate at a startling rate. The Slaugth are impervious to age, to disease, and to poison, and are only vulnerable to the most extreme of injury. Their alien minds are coldly savage and are psychic voids filled with a monstrous hunger for the dead. They are able to produce necrotic fluid from their body tissue, consisting of flesh-eating bacteria and molecular acids able to liquefy flesh or even burn through metal. The strange technology of the Slaugth, combined with their unusual appearance, has led many to believe they are actually demonic creatures. Above all other kinds, the Slaugth crave the dead flesh of other sentient beings, with a particular fetish for consuming cranial matter, which gives them a narcotic experience. Some say that this allows them to consume the memories and knowledge of their victim, and this theory is based in truth. Thus, while the Slaugth gain a more pleasurable narcotic experience from consuming rotting brain matter, they prefer to consume fresh brain too, for the purpose of gathering information. The memories gained from this process fade in just a few weeks unless reinforced, repeatedly used, or externally recorded. Restraint is not a known concept among the racial hubris of the Slaugth, and so they don't see their obsessive hunger as interfering with their intellect. They are known to be very intelligent, highly resilient, and by human standards, entirely evil. Among the known Slaugth are the principals serving as overseers of the Amaranthine Syndicate, though whether they are a true leadership caste or just a particular cabal is unknown. The so-called Destructors are capable of taking a human guise, and have dedicated themselves to the pursuit of destruction above all else. They are also able to revert to their real form, a nightmarish mass of writhing white forms. Another known rank is the Intendant, who serve as leaders of the Slaugth in field operations. The Slaugth possess a mastery of biomechanical technology and elemental physics, exceeding even the knowledge of the Eldar. Among their more mysterious capabilities is the capacity to travel interstellar distances without using the warp. Many of their devices are actually grown or augmented pseudo-living machines, which blend both flesh and metal in a functional symbiosis. Their weapons and artifacts can appear as products of warpcraft to the uninitiated. This keen and terrible grasp of bioscience allows them to grow armies instead of training them. Their array of constructs can be adapted to serve as guards, as spies, and even laborers. When they desire to pass unseen and conceal their horrifying form, the Slaugth make use of multi-layered robes and mantles known as shroud cloaks, which both absorb and refract light. These cloaks seem to writhe and move as if alive, yet they allow their wearers to pass, at a distance, as misshapen humans. Shroud armor is another form of ragged cloak which allows the wearer to disappear from sight, by projecting a strange effect that clouds the perception of the outsiders, thus making them practically invisible. Their weapons include the so-called necrotic scepter, a corroded-looking device pulsing with sickly light, which unleashes arcs of eerie energy when fired. Though a potent long-range device, it is also capable of being used as a melee weapon. Other weapons include the little-understood necrotic beams, used on shock constructs that can turn their targets into dust. A weapon of high rank is the necrotic lance used by the intendants, a long-bladed spear made of swirling strands of bilious energy. With a simple command, these lances project devastating bolts of energy that can even destroy battle tanks. The Slaugth's biomechanical constructs induce revulsion in humanity, though they can widely differ in appearance. In general, most vassal constructs are asymmetrical floating columns of mottled, fungal-looking flesh, covered by pulsing veins, lattices of metal fretwork, and crystalline studs. Their heads are clusters of waving, frond-like sensory growths, with skeletal pincer limbs forming from their body mass when required. A so-called harvest construct appears as a vehicle-sized, amorphous mass of rippling wet flesh that silently floats above the ground. Its mission is to search for sentient matter to consume for its masters, and it pursues this goal relentlessly. When it finds a target, a harvester uses its metallic pincer-tipped tendrils to pull its prey into the lamprey-like mouth. During this feeding, the prey's head is separated and preserved in a semi-transparent sac located at the back of the construct, storing the brain matter safely for future Slaugth feeding. The warrior vassal constructs are a more militarized version of these biomechanical creations. These pale, oval masses of fungal flesh are filled with purple veins and metal lattices. Movement is provided via free, skeletal, spider-like legs, with their upper torso consisting of thick, stumpy tubes filled with a mass of tendrils surrounding a radial, fang-filled maw. Each tendril is surprisingly strong and able to stretch into sharp bone blades. The constructs are not limited to their tendrils alone, but are also equipped with a beam weapon embedded in the body. This necrotizing beam weapon is capable of disintegrating a man in a second. And this, my friends, has been what I wanted to tell you about this incredibly creepy alien race known as the Slaugth for today. Turns out you don't need chaos or necrons or anything major to literally die of fear. These guys are more than capable of doing it on their own. Are the Slaugth among your favorite minor Xenos factions in 40k? What do you like or dislike most about them? Do you know of any other aspects or information about them that I didn't mention today? Feel free to share it, or any thoughts or questions you might have, in the comments below. Was the episode informative or entertaining? In that case, please click the like button and subscribe for future content. Thank you very much for watching, and I wish you all an awesome day. The Emperor protects.